Hey guys!
We're here today to check out a Patreon request from this Patrono right here. As to check out Naglfar with the song Black God Aftermath, which I think it's the episode that came after the last episode of Lucifer.
Oh, yeah, because God is black in Lucifer.
I know, but he retired. Yeah. Because Lucifer then became God, or the big boss. Or
the big boss man.
Whatever the fuck you want to call it. I love that show. It's really one of the greatest shows on TV. Well, not anymore. It's done.
Yeah.
It's over now. It's over. Anyhow, but do you think that show was better because Lucifer had a British accent?
I think that did play into it, the fact that he had a British accent.
I'm starting to think that everything with a British accent is better.
It's like Rufus Rice.
Or English commentators on the footy.
Yeah.
On the footy.
I can't watch footy without...
World Cup.
I can't watch...
I have to have my English commentators. I have to have
the English commentators,
yeah. I can't have some guy from, like, I don't know... Bangladesh doing the commentary. Nothing against Bangladesh, but you know what I'm saying?
Yeah,
even the Portuguese guys don't muster it for me.
I think when it comes to, like, if it's any, like, language other than English, it has to either be Spain or Portuguese, in my opinion. Because they go really fast.
Because of the golo?
Yeah.
They go on for, like, forever.
They go on forever.
All right, that has nothing to do with this video, but hey, we talked about it anyhow. So are you ready for this?
Yeah.
By the way, it's not a video, it's just an audio track.
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, yes. fuck, that was fucking amazing.
What a way to end it off, too.
I know, with the piano at the end there. Unexpected, but works really well. Nice and
soft to end off.
Yeah, for something that's so aggressive, so intense, to finish off on that note, fucking amazing. Anyways, what do you think about this track?
I mean...
Black God Aftermath.
You kind of said a little bit what I was going to say. This song was an absolute brutal, just not stop and go, but I feel like the song and the riff of the song was like revving an engine, right? It was the dun dun, and then it would pull back a little bit and then rev it again, pull back and then rev it again.
But never stopped.
But I liked that because even though that riff was the predominant sound you got throughout the song, it didn't feel stale at any point.
No, it never got boring. Nothing got boring. Because of the drive of the track doesn't let it really get boring.
Exactly. And the song switches up and then goes right back to it. So even though you get a little bit away from it, it still somehow doesn't get that overplayed factor in your brain.
Even though it is.
Even though it clearly is.
Yeah.
It just doesn't hit there, which is funny, but...
And for a song that goes over the 6-minute mark, I mean, that's something to be said.
That is something to be said, because
you would think a song that goes that long with a riff that gets that much playtime...
It would become stale.
Yeah.
But didn't.
It didn't.
It's something hard to do.
It is hard to do.
It's very hard to do, but...
But I think it comes down to
the whole structure of the song.
Yeah, the way the song is structured, the way the vocals come in, with the, like, permeating the darkness of the vocals, not just the heaviness and the harshness, but the darkness that the vocals have just kind of spread out like tentacles throughout the sound of the song. So that helps. The fact that the song is like pedal to the metal,
pulse of the wall.
You were talking about revving. Talk about revving. Pedal to the metal from beginning to end. I think that plays a huge factor in that in that freshness that the song has throughout his entire existence. You don't get tired of listening to it because the whole time I'm listening to this song and I'm like, it's like you're in a car and he's just fucking going. Like, you know, there's no stop signs, there's no traffic, there's no nothing. It's just you in the open highway and you're just fucking going. You know what I mean? That's kind of how this song feels to me.
2 a.m.
Not in Toronto, because at 2 a.m, I've been stuck in traffic on the 401.
Four in the morning, I'll say.
3 a.m. in Chicago. 3 a.m. Fuck, you know, I had to plug my boy.
Your boy?
Yeah, well, he doesn't know yet.
But one day he'll be on the channel.
One day he'll be on the channel. Fuck, I would love to have him. I would love to have him on the channel. I know it's not metal, but...
It's music.
But it's fucking great music, nevertheless. I love those blues, man. The fucking guy's incredible. I think that driviness that the song has, that push forward that the song has, like I said, I was listening to this track and I was closing my eyes ever so slightly thinking, man, in the car, fucking revving and just playing this shit as loud as your
car. Not your car.
No, it has to be a muscle car.
A muscle car, yeah.
It has to be a fucking muscle car.
With the fucking thing at the front.
The motor?
The motor at the front.
Like coming in the scoop out of the hood?
Yeah.
Like Fast and the Furious?
Fast and the Furious.
Or were you Vin Diesel?
It has the fire coming out and everything.
Were you Vin Diesel now?
Yeah. Family, man.
Family?
Yeah.
What do you mean family? Is that related to any of...
Yeah, but it's Fast and the Furious.
It's family. Oh, okay, family, okay. I get it now. I was like, family? Since when are the two of you related? Anything else?
You guys are more related than...
I think I have more in common with him than you. Yeah. I have a pair of diesel pens.
You could be his stunt double.
Nah, I'm too fat.
It'd be really funny just to see like a fight scene and out of nowhere he gets punched to fly through a wall and it's just you.
It is me? All right. Yeah, that's not going to happen. But anyways, anything else you want to add to this incredible Patreon request? I must say... when it comes to Patreon, it's kind of hit and miss, but this one is definitely a
requests
hit.
Requests in general is very hit and miss if we're not like, you know, I don't know how to say it. I feel like if we go into the song and we look at it, we look at everything and we're like, okay, there's a red flag here, red flag here. We're very picky when it comes to requests.
Yes and no.
Sometimes.
Sometimes.
But today, there was no need to be picky.
No, but when I saw the name of the band, it's not like I wasn't familiar with the band. So of course. I saw the name of the band, I kind of figured, okay, this is going to be good.
Yeah, but we didn't know how good.
But exactly. I didn't know exactly what I was going to get, but I knew it was going to be good. It's not like you're picking one of those requests that, fuck, I've never heard of this band.
Those are the ones.
And the name is weird.
Listen.
The name is weird.
Listen, though.
And when when you search in the video on YouTube, it has like 1,000 views, and I'm like... Fuck, nothing is going right here.
I must say,
the stars are not aligning.
I must say, as much as we talk shit, I love doing those type of videos because you don't know what's going to happen. And if it's good, it's a nice surprise. If it's bad, it's...
Normally, when it's bad, it's really bad.
When it's bad, it's really bad, but it becomes an entertaining video.
That is true. I'll give
our
you
most
that.
Entertaining, in my opinion, our most entertaining videos are the ones that are, like, really bad songs.
From Patreon.
Not even from Patreon, just songs in general.
I know, but I love... I'm with you on that. I think when I pick a Patreon request from a band that I've never heard before, like, I've never heard of the band.
It goes one of two ways. And then, either way, the video will be
good. It's
like
this. You've never heard of the band. Nobody on the channel has ever mentioned the name of the band besides this person on Patreon. Yeah, so there's a chance the person on Patreon...
Is in the band.
Then you look up the video. You don't watch it. I just look up the video so I can download the video for the purpose of us recording this. And I see that it has, like, 500 views. And it's posted on the band's own... YouTube channel.
And it's been there for like 2 years.
Yeah, and they have like 100 subscribers. So it's like red flag after red flag. Like, I mean, everything is pointing towards a disaster.
But there's only two ways it could go. There's only two.
We found some amazing gems like that.
It could be an amazing gem out of nowhere, and we need to promote this band right away because they're not getting obviously the airtime that they need. But then it could also be the other way around. The complete shit show, but still an entertaining video because we usually just rip it to shreds.
By the way, before we go, I want to let you know that remember the video we did for Feared?
I was going to say, remember the Titans.
No. Remember the video we did for Feared that started off with a guy with his pants down, like we could see the plumber's crack and whatever?
Oh, yeah.
And I was saying that it looks like Ola from Solar Guitars on it. Yeah, that was him.
That was him.
Yeah, that's his band. Yeah, was his band. Okay. So yeah. I just in case you didn't read the comments, but anyhow. All right, guys, this is it for this video. Come back tomorrow. We'll have more videos for you. See ya.
See ya.